Greetings. As I was studying the Quran, I found this. It is one example of Mohammed's thinking and rationalization to equip Mohammedans against Jews and Christians. Sura 5.18. Musin Khan. And both the Jews and the Christians say, "We are the children of Allah and His loved ones." Say, "Why then does He punish you for your sins? Nay, you are but human beings of those He has created. He forgives whom He wills, and He punishes whom He wills. And to Allah belongs the dominion of the heavens and the earth, and all that is between them, and to Him is the return." And maybe we need to read it slow to really catch just how many things there are wrong with this revelatory word from Allah. And both the Jews and the Christians say, "We are the children of Allah and His loved ones." Well, first of all, it sounds good because both Christians and Jews do both see God as our Father. But realize this is an English translation of Muhammad's Quran. The English word for God is, well, God, not Allah. We do not, and never have, followed the pagan moon god Allah of Arabia. But we'll overlook that melon for a moment. Say, why then does He punish you for your sins? So here is Muhammad, having just given the straw man position of Jews and Christians, giving his followers his best Mohammedan logic to refute the Jewish and Christian position. Muhammad reveals much of both his understanding and his cultural bias. Don't punish, don't correct, don't admonish your loved ones. Well, the Word of God and His prophets and His apostles taught a lot about raising children or your loved ones. I am going to treat loved ones as synonymous for children, because Muhammad established that as his straw man. We are the children of Allah, and therefore His loved ones. What did Prophet Solomon, peace be upon him, say about child rearing? Proverbs 22:15, foolishness is bound in the heart of a child, but the rod of correction shall drive it far from him. Proverbs 23:13-14, do not withhold discipline from a child. If you strike him with a rod, he will not die. If you strike him with a rod, you shall save his soul from Sheol, or hell. And what else does the Word of God say? Hebrews 12:5, and you have forgotten the exhortation which speaks unto you as unto children. My son, despise thou not the chastening or correction and punishment of the Lord, nor faint when you are rebuked of Him. Verse 6, for whom the Lord loves, He chastens, or corrects, punishes, and scourges every son whom He receives. Think about that. Do you punish your child, or do you punish everyone else's children? And I'm not talking to stupid liberals here who think the village should be raising their child for them. The answer is you raise your children. Verse 7, if you endure chastening, God dealeth with you as with sons. For what son is he whom the father chastens not? And that begs a huge question. Do you even want God to treat you like a son? Can you handle the God of all knowing what you do is wrong and caring enough to correct you? Verse 8, but if you be without chastisement, whereof all are partakers, then are you bastards and not sons. If you reject God's correction, you are rejecting God's fatherly love for you. You are acting like a little bastard. Furthermore, we have had fathers of our flesh which corrected us, and we gave them reverence. Shall we not much rather be in subjection unto the Father of spirits and live? You see, our earthly fathers correct us, but they are just imperfect men. And still we respect our fathers for doing their best. For they verily for a few days chastened, or corrected, or punished us after their own pleasure. But he, God, for our profit, that we might be partakers of his holiness. Our earthly fathers correct us for their own pleasure or purpose, but God does so for our profit, to bless us and teach us, and to give us or make us partakers of his holiness. And Mohammed dares to ignorantly ask, why does God punish us for our sins? Mohammed was a pagan idol worshipper who had no God to correct him. Of course Mohammed had no idea of a God who punishes those he loves to save them from sinful behavior. I mean, really, the pagan ideas Mohammed spread are just garbage. And yet Mohammed thought this was a great idea to challenge Christian and Jewish beliefs? The Bible teaches us the truth about the God of Abraham, who loves us and corrects us. And yes, that means punishing our sins. But your leader Mohammed was oblivious to this teaching of the prophets. What kind of a man would make up a religion for an Allah who did not correct or punish sin? What kind of a man claims to be a prophet for a God but knows nothing of the previous message that God had sent? A false prophet who deserves the flames of his punishment. Now, no chastening for the present seems to be joyous, but grievous. Nevertheless, afterward it yields the peaceable fruit of righteousness unto them which are exercised thereby. If you have any regard for the truth, you want to know when you are wrong. And if you have any respect for God, you will desire his punishment to correct you and save you. I mean, really, the pagan ideas Mohammed spread are just garbage. The Word of God teaches us the reason God corrects us. Can you see the difference? Mohammed thought he was clever devising his answer to attack Jews and Christians, but his very argument proves he is a false prophet with a false message. Think about his position and his teaching one more time. And both the Jews and the Christians say, we are the children of Allah and his loved ones. Say, why then does he punish you for your sins? Can you see the complete ignorance of his completely human rationalization? And can you see the Word of God supplies a complete, coherent, and correct answer to Muhammad's false teaching? May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.